Okay, we want to talk about how to create a 3D globe and or planet, and you can see right here that I have an example of what we're going to be making. It could be either a moon, an earth, globe, or some type of planet. The point being is that we're going to create it both in the classic mode and the Viz Render Engine mode so that you can see how to create this with both types of materials. First, we're going to go into the classic mode of Vizrt Artist and do it that way. So we're going to come into our scene here and hit our render engine, our little R, and we're going to switch over to the classic, and we're going to start to build a globe and or planet type 3D object. And to start, what we're going to do is go into our plugins here, and we can start with our sphere. Now I'm going to make a group and put everything inside of that group. So you can see I have a group here and then just a sphere. We're going to go into the transformation editor here, and we can just scale this sphere up to 3 or whatever you want. And within my asset view, I imported several different images already, or we already had them imported. And you can get these images basically anywhere. You can go to NASA.gov and or a stock photo site and grab some maps of an Earth, and we also have some clouds here and a gradient map as well. We also have a little circular image here that we're going to use as well that we created in Photoshop and imported into Vizrt. So first I have a couple of maps here that have a globe or a map on it, and each one is a little bit different. So here's a very blurred one. We can drop that on it, and then we have one that's not so blurred. And maybe we'll just use that one. We'll drop that one on it. We'll come click on the texture that we dropped onto the sphere, and we'll go into the texture editor here, and we'll come down here and change this mapping from linear, which is the default, to the vertex, and it changes that mapping here. Now we're going to use these images and a couple of plugins to enhance this further. So first I'm going to go into my plugins here, and I want to go into my global folder. And we're going to look for the expert, and we're going to drag the expert down onto there. Now I'm also just going to copy this sphere, so I'm going to hold down control, click on it, and just drag, and you can see a little plus sign there right where my mouse cursor is, and when I let go, it creates a brand new sphere that copied everything with it. So now I'm going to replace this map, the Earth map, with another map. So I'm going to go into my asset view here and just replace that one with a gradient instead, and you can see what type of effect we're getting there now with that. Now we also want to kind of create another gradient here, so I'm going to drag our gradient map onto our topmost group here, and I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to use this property called Inheritable Images or Texture Units. So I'm going to click on the map, the gradient map, and we're going to come down to our multi texturing here, and we're going to turn that on, and we're going to change that to number 2, and then we have a slight gradient here at the coming from the bottom as well. And if you wanted to go in there and readjust it further and rotate it and or scale it up to adjust it, you could do that as well. I'm going to close this group for a moment. I'm going to create another group here, and I'm just want to slide this ring up onto it. And I'm going to click on that ring and or the transformation editor here. And I'm going to scale that up until I start to see the outside of it here, roughly right about there. Now I need to grab another plugin, and this time we're going to look for a plugin called Look At, which is in our global folder. So I'm going to go ahead and grab this Look At, and I'm going to place that right onto this ring image, and I'm going to click on the Look At plugin. I'm going to go over to the billboard, and that's just going to keep it facing the camera all the time. And we selected the billboard so that if we ever rotate this within a container, that it will always face it. So for instance, if I group this and place these two inside a group and then rotate this group, you can see that the image, circular image, is staying facing us the whole time, and it's not being affected by that rotation that we are doing on the topmost group. Finally, if we wanted to add some other things like clouds to this, we could copy this group here, and now we have 2. So what I'm going to do is come into our images, into the asset view, and we have a couple of cloud maps here that we could use. So we could drag one of these cloud maps up onto our container here, And we also have an expert on it since we copied it. And since that is already on it, we could change this to a different setting in here, maybe add or one of the other settings to get where you want. If it's too much, we could also go in and add an alpha to it just to bring it down a little bit so that you can see less of the clouds and more of the earth. There is an extra container here that since we copied it, and if you want to turn that off, it will again affect it a little bit more. So here's a quick way to make a globe or some type of planet within the classic mode of Vizrt. Once you have it set up and you have different maps, you could certainly go into your different images then and swap out for what you need. So for instance, a moon instead of the earth map, you could slide that on there, hide one of these, and there you go. You can swap it out quite quickly. If you need to merge this and then save it, you could collapse it or put it all in one topmost group. You could select it and then you can come up here where it says merge with actions and events, and it will create it all in one group. And then you can come down into your G tab, select a certain folder, and just drag that down into there, give it a name, you hit OK, and then whenever you're in a new scene or you delete something out of your scene, you can just drag that group right back into it. And once you have that group, you can also then split it so that you have access to all the different containers within it. Now we're going to switch over to the Viz Engine Render Mode and try to do it the exact same thing within that and recreate the scene there. So I'm going to go into the scene setting again into our R function, and this time I'm going to change it to Viz Engine Renderer. And we're going to go into our plugins again, and we're going to go down to our default. We'll start again with a sphere, and we'll click on the transformation editor. We'll go into our scale and we'll just scale that up to 3. Now what we need to do is use our PBR images. So first that means we're going to need our certain plugin, and we're going to go into our global plugins here and we're going to look for our PBR material, and we're going to drag that onto our sphere up here. And once we do that, it creates this little icon here. It looks a little bit different than it did in the classic mode. If we click on this icon here, it opens up this new area here where we have to drag our images into it. But before we do that, we have to go into our settings here and use some type of environment map. So I'm going to go back into my asset view, and I have a couple of environment maps that we can use here. So I'm going to go into my images tab, and within my asset view, I have some environments which have been pre-filtered already. And if you have an environment map, you would just need to click on that and pre-filter environment map. And once you do that, you get this little red icon on the environment map. And once you have the red icon, you can slide it into the environment map, which is in your scene settings. So once we do that, you can see it takes on a little bit of shading here. And so far, that's what we have. Now we need to go into our PBR materials here and start dragging them in there. And again, I've imported several different images, which I've got from stock sites and or a 3D site where you can buy 3D models and or maps. And you can also go to free sites like NASA.gov. In this case, it was really useful for images for the Earth and moon, and the images that I imported here are in a particular folder. So if you watch the other tutorials on how to set up your PBR scenes, you know that we need to start dragging these images into the corresponding boxes here. So we need to start dragging our images into here, and first we can start with our color image or main image. We can drag that up in there, and you can see that it's going to take it on there. From now we have our additional images which we can drag up there. We also have a normal in this case, which we can put on there. We have a metallic, which we'll slide up into there. And then we also have an emissive color, which we could use as well. So we'll slide that up into there. And you can see that it's taking on that blue. And at any time we have an intensity next to it, so we can increase and or decrease the intensity of each one of these maps individually as well. So this is going obviously going to be very dependent upon which images you use in here and which separate images you use for your mapping. And much of that will determine how your globe comes out. From there, you can also do additional texturing. For instance, we could come into our plugins and use this texture slot as well once we are in the Viz Engine Render Mode. Whereas before we used the Inheritable Image, now within the Fusion Engine Mode, you can use the texture slots. And you can come over to your asset view again, and you can find some images that you want to use. If I want to combine this like gradient image, I could drag that on there, and now it has a little bit of a gradient as well. If you wanted to add another one, you could just come up here and give it a name, and we could hit plus right there. And if you wanted to add some clouds or something too, you could certainly try that, and then come down to your other settings within the texture slot, and you can have a whole other list of settings here that we could add as well. So we could change our color blend mode from add all the way down to multiply to vivid light, the same settings that you get if you're familiar with Photoshop. So you have a lot of different settings in here that you could use to tweak and or adjust the design of your globe. And once we come in here and rotate it around, you'll see how it's affecting. We could also add lights, background, and other things. So this is a quick overview of how to quickly create 3D objects like a planet and or globe using both the Classic Render Mode and the Viz Engine Render Mode. Hope that helps. Thanks.